Hey guys!
Alright guys, we're here today to do a request from one of our viewers. This viewer right here asked us to check out a video from Lacuna Coil, Layers of Time. We haven't done Lacuna Coil in a long time on the channel. So I thought, let's throw this viewer a bone and check out some Lacuna Coil for him. And I'm sure other people will be thrilled with the fact that we're checking out some more Lacuna Coil. Alright, are you ready for this? Are you ready for some Italian metal?
Yeah.
Che cosa?
Babarubi?
Biburubi babari? Alright, let me put my headphones on, and before we embarrass ourselves any further, let's click play. All right, I'm gonna let you go first on this one.
I like those male vocals in the background there for throughout the song. They're very, very I don't know how to explain it, but they're very powerful, yet not being in the forefront.
So they had a strong presence, even though not necessarily they were.
They
always
were the main thing.
Well, it's sometimes
they would, like in the end there, they came in as like one of the main things. But
even at the beginning of the song,
he
alternated whenever
he alternated between when she would come in with her vocals, he would kind of go into the background, but still had a strong presence, even though not being in the forefront.
So what you're saying is that even though he had a strong presence, obviously when he was in the forefront, but when he moved into the background, it still lingered.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
And I really really like that because his it covered a wide range of sound, and it was a very thick sound, just kind of.
It was powerful.
A very powerful sound, yeah, moving throughout.
Even
the
though
track.
They were not necessarily superly heavy, they had a strong presence to
them.
Yeah,
because there was like a chant.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. I want to say a couple of things. One thing I want to say is anybody that plays the bass, like they're tying their shoelaces,
yeah,
that's a friend of mine in my books. I love that, I don't know, that so badass way of. Like, he was so low at times playing the bass.
I feel like. If he does that during a show and then he gets up at the end of the show, like he straightens out his back, and you hear a crack.
I honestly could never do that. I have the worst back ever.
I couldn't do that during a 2-minute song.
No, I couldn't do that.
A 4-minute song.
But anybody that plays the bass at any point in time of the song and they're playing it like they're tying their shoelaces, to me that's like badass to the extreme. I just wanted to say that. Now, what did you think of the grooviness? Like there was two moments of the song right before her vocals come in. That you get like this really like almost a gent like grooviness to it. It was like so cool.
Yeah.
The sound was so cool.
It went into the song and then it had like a cool presence into the song. And it was weird. It wasn't like anything else that was being done in the song.
Yeah, it had a very uniqueness to it.
Yeah,
had a uniqueness to
That's
it.
A word.
But it was so groovy and it was so. I mean, it was so different. Like, there was nothing before.
And nothing after.
And then after, that was even close to it. But that moment, whenever I heard that, I was like, oh my God.
It's very special.
It's like it's hitting all the right spots. Like, I just loved the way it sounded. It was just so interesting. It had such an interesting sound. I also like the way the song finishes because, from a vocal perspective, because you have him in the forefront, he drops out, she comes in for the chorus. Then he comes in again for the verses. He drops out. She comes in again for the chorus. But then at the end, she gets more. She stays on.
Yeah.
In the track, and he starts to become more of the backing vocalist at that point in time. But the song finishes vocally. I felt it finished really. It was strong all the way through,
it
but
finished,
it finished really
it
on,
also,
a, on a high
it
note.
It also finished the way it started with him.
Yeah, but it finished on. I felt like the song was from a vocal perspective, even though there's this. What do you call it? Like the switching between the song is very balanced in terms of how it's put together vocally.
You don't
from the
feel
beginning
the, you don't
the
feel
end.
The switch does anything to the song.
I felt that obviously her voice brings a little bit more of a melody,
well,
more
I'm
it lightens
about
up
I'm
the track,
about, like messing up anything.
Oh,
the
it was perfect.
It was a very fluid switch.
100%. 100%. The song didn't feel chopped at all. Like the two styles are complete. Opposite. I mean, they're very different.
But they were able to move over each other very.
Yeah, and I think the song musically changed just enough to really adapt or to embrace what was happening vocally.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? So it's not like the song is staying status quo from the beginning all the way to the end, and nothing is happening there. It's just like a straight line, and all that's happening is the vocals are going up and down. No, the song didn't change too much, but just enough to really accommodate what was happening vocally. And I think that's why the transition between the two is so smooth. This track is like a little bit of a Jekyll and Hyde kind of song, because as much of heaviness as it, and it's not a super heavy song, but it is a heavy track.
Yeah.
You know, for as much as of heaviness that this song has, it also has so much melody. So it's like, it's heavy, but at the same time, it's levitating. It's soft, it's light, but it's heavy.
Yeah.
And it's always finding this perfect balance between the two.
You.
No, it's a perfect track. The way it's put together, it's just, you embrace the both sides the same way. It's not like...
One is better than the other.
No, and it's not like one of those songs that when you're listening to one part and you're like, oh, I wish there was more of this and less of the other.
No, it was balanced perfectly throughout the song.
And delivered perfectly. Yeah. Because sometimes you're like, oh, you know, this is nice, but I can't wait it to be over so I can get to...
What's next?
And this song, I didn't feel that way. I felt like I was enjoying...
Every part
of it. You know what I mean? Like, I really love this track. The vocals... Both vocalists absolutely delivered on this song.
Yeah,
I felt like they had just a very consistent approach and their voices, while so different, they intertwine perfectly. Which is another reason why you don't feel like there's a drop or that the song is choppy. They have the ability of being different but completing each other. With, you know, one adds something to the other and the other adds something to the other. And so they kind of bring the best out of both of them together. I felt that way listening to this track. And the heaviness that it has, the lightness that it has, the mixture of the two. What a fun track.
Yeah.
Really good song. Really good song. Thank you to our viewer that asked us to check out this track. We've been sleeping a little bit on Lacuna Coil. We haven't done them that much on the channel, but I think that's going to change. We had some issues with El Copyrightos.
Yeah.
So the label will help us out if anything goes sideways. So we'll be able to check more from Lacuna Coil. All right, guys. Come back tomorrow. We'll have more videos for you. See you guys.
See ya.